بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله الأطهار وعلى أصحابه الميامين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله شهادة تنجي قائلها من عذاب أليم، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. يقول الله تبارك وتعالى في محكم تنزيله: ونزلنا عليك الكتاب تبيانا لكل شيء وهدى ورحمة للمسلمين. صدق الله العلي العظيم. Respected brothers, and I believe the sisters also they are there. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We really can't express ourselves, or we can't thank Allah enough to be among those who are in Ramadan. A lot of brothers and a lot of sisters last year, they had the intention that they will fast this Ramadan, but only to find out that some they are still alive, but the situation can't allow them. But you and I, being in the position that we can fast, alhamdulillah, that we can't thank him enough. My brothers and sisters, let me go direct on the topic. Since we are in the month of Ramadan, we are in the month of Quran. Shahr Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Quran. It will be unjustifiable if I can talk to something, tell you something else than Quran itself. My brothers and sisters, we learn. I was looking where to start. From Bahar al-Amir, from this biggest ocean called Kitabullah, the Quran. And by the mercy of Allah, by His acceptance, I got the angle. And that is no one else except what I'm going to explain you, what I learned from Imam Hussein, Salamullahi alayhi. Brothers and sisters, you know who is Imam Hussein? Imam Hussein is the son of Fatima al-Zahra. And Fatima al-Zahra is the daughter of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So what Hussein tell us, he got it from nowhere else except from the Bahar itself, the ocean itself, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. What Imam Hussein taught us about Quran. He says that this book of Allah, when you put ITV, when you put Ahl Bayt TV, when you put any channel about where Muslims are majority, you will see that each and everyone open Quran and reading Quran. When you are busy, when we are busy reading Quran, we are in the four category. I want you and I to check which category are you in. It's not me who said so, that is Imam Hussein Salamullahi alayhi. He says that Kitabullah Azza wa Jalla ala arba: ala al-ibara wal-ishara wal-lataif wal-haqa'iq. That this book of Allah, when we read it, they are among of us, the group of us who are in ibara. They are the group of us who is in ishara. They are the group of us who are in the lataif. And they are that zone, which is noko zone. That is haqa'iq. That is noko zone. As we will see it, inshallah. So he went further and he says, al-ibara, they are those who are reading Quran lil awam. Lil awam means that we are reading Quran, we are getting lesson from it. Either believer or non-believer, my brothers and sisters, people read Quran. Don't think that we are the only one who read Quran. But they read Quran with a different intention. Others want to know exactly what makes these people to be hungry from morning to evening. He's doing his research, he's busy reading. In the end of the day, he is getting lesson out of it. That is the awam. Now from awam, then he says there are those who are reading Quran, the group of Ishara, that is the Hawas, specialists. This one who are specialists, when he opened the book of Allah and he reached this verse, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. He's not reading, it is not worried too much about what is idhar, what is ikhfa, what is ikhla, ahkam tajweed, what? But he wants to know how to use Quran in his own everyday life. That is al-khawas. Check where are we? And he says that there are those, but although this khawas, from khawas, it comes three categories. For instance, I will come with this verse. I know that we are in the month of Quran. When we are busy reading Quran, we found it out this verse in the Surah Al-Waqi'ah. When Allah tabaraka ta'ala, he says, فَلَوْلَا إِذَا بَلَغَتِ الْحُلْقُومِ وَأَنْتُمْ حِينَئِذٍ تَنْظُرُونَ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْكُمْ وَلَكِنْ لَا تُبْصِرُونَ. When a brother or a sister read this verse of Quran, when Allah says that, check, when one of you, Israel, bring the soul until here, taking it out, you see the brother is about dead, dying, and the end of the death are near to him, but you and I can't see, and we can't see them. When a brother read that, or a sister read that, he see, he believe, because he have a mother who died, or he have a brother who died. So he have this ilm al-yaqeen, the knowledge of the certainty, that definitely the death it is coming. But since the death is coming to me, what I am going to present to Allah tabaraka ta'ala, when that moment come, standing before whom I can't imagine. Now, this brother or this sister, when he's busy fasting, because Allah commanded us to fast, his fasting is based on that fear for what is going to happen on the day when he will meet Allah tabaraka ta'ala. We're talking about now the khawas, because awam, I says, we read it. But there are this al-khawas, the special, that when you read and you reach the verse which talk about death, you know that the death, it is coming, you start to check about your duty. When the time of the salah comes, you will stop everything and perform salah. Your performing salah is based on what will happen, the repercussion later on. There is this group. There's this second one. The second one, we call it Ayn al-Yaqeen. You know in the Surah Takathur? There's Ilm al-Yaqeen, there's Ayn al-Yaqeen. Ayn al-Yaqeen here is that this brother, he know and he believe there's a death. And he know that one day the death it will come to him. But that's not only based on the knowledge of knowing, he see the death approaching him. Now this person, when he's busy reading Quran, his understanding of the Quran and his reading of the Quran, he knows very well that when Allah he says fast, kutiba alaykum as-siyam, what is going to happen to him, he knows exactly what's going to end. So his ibadah is based on, inshallah, there's something called the Jannah. No matter how hungry you could feel, but there's a Jannah. Because he have Ayn Yaqeen. But the Surah Al-Waqi'ah is telling us about Haqqul Yaqeen. The other one, when he read about the verse of death, he does not see death coming to him. That we talk about Khawas. We all read in Quran, and you read the verse which he says, "Kullu nafsin da'iqatul maut." But I don't know. Can you please? The third one, what will happen? Or what happened to him in this second category of the people who are reading Quran? This one, he know about the death, he have ilm al-yaqeen that definitely certainty death it will come one day. Ayn al-yaqeen, he have that ayn al-yaqeen, but he superseded ayn al-yaqeen into haqq al-yaqeen. What happened to this human being? He does not only see the death, but he have this in Arabic called it tasawwur, and he have now tasdeer. He see himself busy making ghusl, people making ghusl to him. He see himself being put down there, and he see the people performing Salat al-Janaza sometime without even wudu. He see himself being carried, and there's someone reciting tahleel. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. So this person, when he's busy reciting Quran, his reciting of the Quran is khassa, he's a specialist, in the such a way that it moves him from the khassa into lataif. Then now when he look at the Quran, he look at it, when he look at the time which we are in, he see it as the extreme kindness of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, to be part and parcel of those who are among of those who are fasting and among of those who are reading Quran. So which means, as you understand, that in life we have, when our mind and our heart and our spirit is in the makabit, and there's a time when our mind and our spirit is in the tamyiz, and there's a time when our mind and our spirit reach from mulkillah. Now this makabit and this tamyiz, which Allah tabaraka ta'ala, he says, وَهَدَيْنَاهُ نَجْدَيْنِ. When you move from khaswa into lataif, you are reading Quran, it is not like my reading Quran. Because you find out, when I'm busy reading Quran, how I am reading Quran? A, I was being told, when you are busy, when you are in Ramadan, Ramadan have 30 days. So since Ramadan have 30 days, at least each and every day, Quran have, Ramadan have 30 days, and Quran have 30 juzu. So each and every day, I must read one juzu. So that in the end of Ramadan, I have completed it. But this itibari in it, no, that's not a main issue. The main issue, as long as I can recite and finish. That's how I was being taught, or that's how we have been taught. Only to find out that is not what required to you and I. What required to you and I is to take this opportunity. When you open Quran, Quran which revealed during the lifetime of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is going to lead us until the day of the judgment. So in our everyday life, when you read the verse of the Quran, it is for you, because Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala have sent to each and every one of us two types of the messenger. There's a two types of the messenger. There's a zahir, there's an open messenger, and there's a batin, and there's a hidden messenger. The open messenger is from Prophet Adam alayhi salam until Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After him, no any other prophet. But that hidden prophet is your conscience, is your intellect. Then when you read Quran, how can I apply it in my everyday life? Unfortunately, we have reduced Quran into mosque. We don't move Quran outside. We don't act Quran in our business. We are now in the month of Quran, so we must read Quran, we finish and go. Only to find out, my brothers and sisters, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, as I explained to you, let me firstly go back a little bit, that there is ibarah which is lil awam, to everybody. There is a khaswa which is the special for you and I as Muslims. And there is lataif, that is for the awliya, those who falling in love towards Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, making all effort day and night to please no one else beside Allah and Allah alone. But there's this, I say, no good zone, haqa'iq. The only one who understands Quran 100%, 1,000,000%, no one else except Muhammad and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So haqa'iq for anbiya, for the prophets. Now my brothers and my sisters, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam what he told him. He says, وَنَزَّلْنَا, we have revealed عَلَيْكَ to you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كِتَابَ, this book, Quran, تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ, this book of the Quran explains everything. Don't reduce Quran only in the mosque here. Don't reduce Quran only in Ramadan. Quran, it is tibyana li kulli shay. It explains everything in any situation which you meet yourself. But after all that, what happened again? Wa rahma. What do you remember? The last, the first 10 days is for Rahmah. Today is the 10th, I believe. Wa Rahmah. Quran, it is the message to you and I. Allah revealed it. There is mercy. We are seeking for the mercy in this month. The Quran has mercy. Wa Hudan. Quran has guidance. Where is the guidance? Guidance does not mean only here in the mosque. Guidance also how to deal with other fellow human beings in our business. Because is it a tradition or no? Ad-dinu mu'amala. Kalimatayn, there are two words. The religion of Allah, it is mu'amala. The relationship, how you deal with the others, how we work with each other. That's what deen. So are you the sign of Allah? Or are you the way you deal with a human being? When you are outside, you are in mall. When you are inside, now you are crying, Allah, Allah, we are in Ramadan, we are in Ramadan. Ramadan is come and Ramadan is go. But the book of Allah is with you, which is tibyana li kulli shay, which explains everything, which is the rahmah to you and I, which is the huda. But guidance to who? Lil Muslimin. I was asking today morning my son that translate to me that word Muslimin. What does it mean? He said, Papa, Muslimin meaning Muslims. And I was very angry. And says, call our classes. He says, oh, now I remember. So what do you remember? Lil Muslimin meaning those who are peaceful minded. Huda wa rahma lil Muslimin. It is a rahma and it is the hidayah to those who are peaceful minded. Go and find out the word salam and Islam, what does it mean? My brothers and sisters, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala again told Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, because Muhammad, I said, is the only one who have haqa'iq. He's the only one who know exactly. So what he taught the Sahaba, then Sahaba taught us, either he taught it or Allah knows. That's what we get. He says, wa anzalna ilayka, Muhammad, we have sent to you dhikra. Here dhikra meaning Quran. لِتُبَيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ مَا نُزِّلَ إِلَيْهِمْ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Allahu Akbar. Again, listen in the beauty of the Quran here. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is saying Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, that Muhammad, we have revealed to you Quran. Your duty, لِتُبَيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ, the best translator and the mufassir, the greatest mufassir of the Quran, the greatest teacher of the Quran is no one else except Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is his duty to explain us exactly what Allah wants and what Allah does not want. For what reason? لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ, so that we can use our mind carefully. My brothers and sisters, we are in the month of Quran. Now, I need to see what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam explained us in Quran, in brief, because we can't finish them. I just tried to take out what we can benefit now. But I know you benefited a lot, the shuyukh teaching, and you're reading Quran every day. I opened Surah Taha. When I opened it, and I read this verse. And this verse says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, verses. Wa anakhtartuka, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, wa anakhtartuka, fastami'a lima yuha, innani ana Allah, la ilaha illa ana, فَعَبُدُنِي وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِلذِّكِرِ إِنَّ السَّاعَةَ آتِيَةٌ أَكَادُ أُخْفِيهَا لِتُجْزَى كُلَّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا تَسْعَى. صدق الله العلي العظيم. Brothers and sisters, Prophet Musa and Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and all the prophets of Allah, they had one thing in common. I wanted to learn what Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam explained us in these verses. Musa alayhi salam, he talked to Allah direct, you all know. Allah is telling Musa, wa ana ikhtartuka, Musa, I have chosen you. Fastami' lima yuha, listen to what I'm revealing to you. Innani ana Allah, I'm your Lord. La ilaha illa ana. The first message which Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala given to Musa alayhi salam, hiya kalimati la ilaha illa Allah. In the same verse, Musa alayhi salam, Allah is telling him, there is something called sa'a, there is something called qiyamah. And in the same time, in the same those verse, Musa alayhi salam, Allah is telling him, you are apostrophe Allah. My brothers and sisters, what is the great lesson in this verse? Let me indicate to you. There are three things which are very important. How important is it, are they? Because through that three things, we are still all brothers and sisters. And that is usul al-aqidah. It's to believe in the prophethood, it's to believe in the oneness of Allah, and to believe in the day of the judgment. In this, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala telling him and telling us. But the word he started with is La ilaha illallah. Again, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, Then we see him, he was being commanded to say, Fa'alam, Muhammad, you must know. What, where to start to explain people about the Quran? Fa'alam, annahu, la ilaha illallah. My brothers and my sisters, the Quran as all, the Torah as all the heavenly book, the foundation, the structure of it is based on kalimat la ilaha illallah. That is what we have learned among of what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam he explained us in the Quran. What did he say? He says, "Afdal ma qultu ana wa nabiyyina min qabl qawl la ilaha illallah." The most word I say, I and all my colleagues, all the prophets before me, la ilaha illallah. Why la ilaha illallah, brothers and sisters? Because this kalimat la ilaha illallah, it has rukunan, it has two rukun, it has two kiras. One, nafyul uluhiyya ama siwallah. And the second one, ifbat al-khaliq al-wahid al-qahhar. And everything is based on that. Kalimat la ilaha illallah. My brothers, my sisters, unfortunately, the time can't allow us. We could go more deeper in that la ilaha illallah. Why Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for 13 years in Mecca he was emphasized sticking to qulu la ilaha illallah tuflihu. If you could understood it, you will not see people killing each other. We will be in harmony. All the misery which you see, our biggest mistake, we don't understand this kalimat la ilaha illallah. And because of that, you know why we are going to hell? Innahum idha qila lahum innahum kanu idha qila lahum la ilaha illallah yastakbirun. When they were telling them, don't do anything to please anybody. Don't insult each other, Shia Sunni, what? Don't insult each other, trying to impress anybody. But do things for Allah and Allah alone. What happened? Those are kafir. This what? We misunderstood that kalimat la ilaha illallah. So my brothers and sisters, when you read Quran, try to reopen more your chest to understand the first teachings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. Qulu la ilaha illallah tuflihu. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi at-tayyibin at-tahirin al-masumin.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Firstly, we thank Mulana Ahmed Kasim for coming out today and giving us his Juma lecture. Secondly, we at the Institute for Islamic Services are collecting Zakat and Lila funds as we do once a year in Ramadan for our ongoing projects such as feeding schemes, daycare centers, medical center, masjid projects, monthly grocery vouchers to 140 families, etc. We ask people to support us and we will be coming around throughout Ramadan. Secondly, inshallah, we will be selling English Qurans at the entrances of the masjid after the remaining salah at 10 rand each only for today. The Quran is full English and perfect to use for dawah and also very easy to understand. It is a pocket-sized Quran and translated by Maulana Wahiduddin Khan. Jazakallah.